What it do, suckers? It's your boy TC3. We back again with more reactions. And today we all Sword Art Online Abridged episode 10. If you have not seen any of my other reactions to any of the other episodes, top right hand corner. I don't know. Wait, which way am I going? Right hand corner. Playlist button. Click it. Come back. You back? What it do, man? If you're new to the community, do me a favor. Like, comment, and subscribe. That only puts me in the algorithm so more suckers like you can find me, man. And let's get into episode 10, man. The last episode, my boy Kirito, he in Kool-Aid. He got some cool. Now, what's about to happen next? Let's find out.
Is owned by A1 Pictures, Aniplex USA, and Reki Kawahara. Please support the official release.
Oh!
Amazing, Kirito.
We picking up right here!
Well, at least one of us enjoyed ourselves.
Excuse me?
Sorry, I can't turn it off. I'm broken. Please fix me.
Wow, that was almost kind of romantic.
Dude, what are you doing? We're blowing this!
What were we supposed to say? We don't even know what made her like us in the first place!
Fine, just calm down. Our part's over. As long as she doesn't throw us any curveballs, I think we're good.
True.
So, what should we do now?
Fuck! What the hell is she talking about? What comes after sex?
I don't know. All the dating sims just go to credits at this point.
Well,
she has a question, sir. We have to say something. Look, just say anything.
Don't say anything.
Anything. Just say it with confidence.
No.
All right. Here goes nothing. We should get married.
No! What? You said say anything.
Anything except that, obviously.
I'm sorry. I don't work well under pressure.
You know what? It's fine. Forget it. We'll just play it off as a joke. No harm done.
Yes, let's do it.
You don't, asshole!
Hey, she seems pretty happy about it. Maybe she knows something we don't.
Bitch, why the fuck did you say yes? Oh, no!
Everybody brain just fucked off at the sex, huh? They just busted a nut and was just like, yeah! Let's get married. To the edge of the earth, the brand new world, it's a brand new world. Hey, you're sturdy in the chair. Hold up, wait, I'm sturdy in the chair. Y'all can't see me, but I'm sturdy as fuck right now.
Ah, Kirito, Asada, thank you for meeting me on such short notice. And might I say, congratulations on the wedding.
Oh, wow.
It's so good.
It's the best decision ever, really. I can't see any potential problems with that.
Young love.
This is the best decision. It's really the best of any decisions anyone has ever made, really.
This nigga.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, you may remember that the ending of our fight was a tad controversial.
Hey, I heard those air quotes, you son of a bitch.
Well, now that they've run out of things to burn, it seems the rioters have reverted to a somewhat primitive tribalistic society, with one player in particular rising up as their leader. They call him the King of Ashes.
Ooh, ominous.
So, in light of these events, I will be heading to Floor 75 to try and engage the King and Fluffles in peace talks.
Fluffles?
Yeah.
Damn it, not Don Fluffles.
Unsurprising twist, it seems Captain Fluffles has turned traitor and joined forces with the Bandit King.
Wow.
Well, well, looks like we caught us a couple intruders. What do you think we ought to do with them, Fluffles?
Aww.
My God, Fluffles, you are one sick kitty.
Damn.
I like it. Bring out the boiling oil.
Oh, I see. So you need me at the table, cracking jokes and breaking the ice. I gotcha.
No.
No! God, no! I need to hide you under the biggest rock I can find!
Excuse me?
How do I put this delicately? Ah, I'm afraid you'll piss someone off and kill thousands.
Yeah, I can see that.
Asana!
I'm sorry, honey, but if it means avoiding the deaths of innocent players, I think the least you can do is sit this one out.
Damn, Kirito!
I need you to stay behind and guard him, Asana.
Oh, screw that noise! I'm coming too!
Look, it'll be great. I prepared a nice little cabin for you guys on floor 22. Beautiful forest, view of the lake. You'll practically have the whole floor to yourselves. Consider it your honeymoon!
But...
Oh!
Oh, well, in that case, that sounds great.
Yep, can't see any problems with that. You, Asana?
Nope, you and me alone in the woods for who knows how long? Sign me the hell up!
You mean you and I.
Ah, young love.
Yeah.
How I envy you.
Young love. So this is side quest honeymoon. Hey, I like this.
Holy balls. The commander wasn't kidding. This place is amazing. Maybe this won't be so bad after all.
Yeah, this is nice. Hey, do you think getting married was the worst mistake of our lives?
Hmm? What are you talking about? You don't want to be married to me? I want to be married to you! Don't you love me?
No, I mean, yes.
What the fuck? What the hell are you doing? That was a route! You know, I did it!
Well, we're in too deep now. You know what Mom says. It doesn't matter if you're wrong. Just dig in your heels and never show weakness.
You ever think that's why Mom and Dad are getting divorced?
No time to unpack that now!
Yes, I mean, no, but yes, no.
Mm. Oh, yeah. I love you so much. I don't regret this at all.
Me too. I love you so much. I don't even know your real name.
They don't know each other's real name.
Okay, Marlo. Why don't we pump the brakes a bit? So, what's your name?
I believe my name is Yui.
Aw, that's a cute name. Remember anything else? Friends? Address? Street corner we can dump you?
No.
This man!
My mama and papa?
Yeah, okay. Let me set you straight, you little fruitcake.
Wait!
We can use this.
What are you-
Huh?
Just follow my lead.
Of course you're our daughter!
What?
Yay!
Okay, I'm lost. How did we get a kid? I have no idea. Why would she lie to her like that? Daughter of a bastard! She doesn't think getting married was a good idea either! She just doesn't want to be the one to say it!
Damn!
Scare us off! Oh, well that's simple then. All we need to do is talk it out like a- Don't you get it? This is a power move! If we let her have this one, she'll hold it over us for the rest of our lives!
What?!
What the hell do we do? Oh, I'll tell you what we do. We play her game. And we win! Welcome home, Yui!
Yay!
And we love you too!
Yui.
Yui, yeah!
Oh my goodness!
What are you reading, Papa?
Nothing interesting.
May I read it when you're done? I'm curious about the geopolitical situation in Colonia.
Yui? Where did you learn a word like that?
Oh, you know. Books.
Like what? The dictionary?
Yeah.
Yes. Is that weird?
Not at all. Our daughter's a pretty smart kid. Isn't she, Asuna?
Thank you, Papa!
Shit! I can't believe he called our bluff!
Oh no! I think we're moving too fast! I know! Let's have a freaking kid! That'll solve all our problems!
Oh, shut up! This could still work. It's not like he actually likes the adorable little troglodyte. Adorable.
Troglodyte?
Shut up!
Troglodyte? That's a cold-ass word.
She's so beautiful when she's sleeping.
Okay, here we go. What's wrong, Asuna?
Oh, I was just thinking about how much I love Yui. But then, when I think about how much her real parents must miss her, must be worried sick looking for her, I just can't stand it. And she doesn't even remember them!
Oh, I know.
He rolled his eyes, bro.
He's screwing you up inside, but whatever are we to do?
We can't keep lying to her. As painful as it'll be to let her go, I think we need to find her real parents.
You're right. I suppose carrying on like this would be pretty irresponsible of us.
So, we're in agreement then?
Yeah, I get it. You totally blinked first.
We would like to buy one child, please! What?
Yeah, you know, to keep this one company!
I don't think you two understand how an orphanage works. You can't just buy a child!
Why stop there? Why not grab two?
You're right, honey. I mean, while we're out. Heck, maybe they got a discount if we buy them in bulk!
I mean, this isn't even a real orphanage. All these kids have parents in the real world.
We'll take a 12-pack if you have it!
Why only 12? Why not share them with all the children?
You're not listening to me.
No.
I see that now.
Ma'am, we would like to buy your orphanage!
Hello, my name is Yulier of the Einkrad Liberation Front. I was told I could find two of the strongest players in the game here. Please, I need your help!
good. Another one. Well, all are welcome in the house of the...
Kirito! And this is my wife, Asuna. Come on in. We're the new owners.
What? I'll make some tea.
Thank you for agreeing to speak with me. This is a lovely place you have here.
They don't actually...
Aw, you're too kind. Please, enjoy my wife's tea.
But I made the tea.
So why exactly do you need our help?
Well, you see, after a series of devastating losses, the ALF has been thrown into a bloodthirsty power struggle. Amidst the chaos and infighting, a contemptible creature by the name of Kibao has been amassing power at a frightening pace.
Kibao? Wait, you don't mean...
Beta testers!
No! Damn. What? How? How could you let this happen?
It all happened so fast! None of us saw it coming! I mean, would you? The man has the unbridled charisma of a Chipotle enema!
Wow.
That's an image.
Before we knew it, there was simply no one strong enough to stand against him. That is, except for Sir Thinker, of course. He
Sir
bravely
Thinker.
And sexily stood against Kibao's tyranny and pleaded for an end to the fighting. For a while, it seemed like his beautiful words and ass were actually getting through to him. Kibao even set up a meeting to discuss a truce in a secret dungeon here on the first floor. But to our surprise, it was nothing but a trap. That vile snake just left my poor Thinker to die down there! That's why I came to you two! Please, you have to help me rescue him!
Why doesn't he just use a teleport crystal to get out?
He thought he was going to a peace talk. He didn't bring any weapons or items with him.
This peace talk, which was held in a dungeon?
I know. That wonderful man gave that bastard the benefit of the doubt, only to walk into a trap. It's quite ironic.
No.
It is not. That is not at all what irony is. I believe the turn of events you describe would be best classified as completely expected.
Basically.
What are you talking about?
Irony. Noun. A state of affairs or an event that seems deliberately contrary to what one expects, and is often amusing as a result. Example. Your leader is named Thinker, yet he appears to be something of a dullard.
Holy cow, Yui, that was amazing! Wish I had like a tiny little mic for you to drop.
Oh my god, that would be adorable! How dare you defile the good name of Thinker! He is the greatest, most intelligent man I have ever known!
Statistically speaking, that says more about you than it does about him.
You wanna take this outside, kid? I'll throw down with an 8-year-old! I don't give a fuck!
Touch her and I kill Thinker myself.
Ooh.
Duly noted. So, can you help me? When I think about how scared he must be down there, it makes me wanna just throw him down and have my...
Yeah, I think I got the picture. Look, lady, I was all for having a nice family adventure, but as our daughter so eloquently put it, that dumbass really should have seen this coming. And besides, this is the first floor. Can't be that hard to get to him. Heck, I bet even Freckles over here could get the job done. What do you say, Freckles? Up for a fetch quest?
Oh, so I can talk now? It's okay for I, Sasha, to talk? You didn't even know my name was Sasha, did you? Did you?
Yeesh, where did that come from? I feel like I'm the only one here who hasn't...
This side quest is turning into a lot of fucking drama. But I fucking love it! I can't believe this shit! This shit is really... Like, I don't know how they concocted this shit, but this shit is getting good. God damn. Fucking Yui is really embodying more fucking Kirito than fucking Kirito can embody himself.
Brenda stabbed someone today.
I have not threatened anyone, Papa.
Oh, yeah. Looks like you and I are the only sane ones here, sweetie.
Gary!
Is he gonna be all right?
Just let him work it out of his system. He'll tire himself out eventually.
If you say so. On a related note, are you at all concerned by the delight your daughter seems to be taking in all this?
Go for the eyes, Papa! That is their weak point!
Not really. Why?
Nope, no reason. You seem like a great family.
Aw, thank you.
Well, Kirito.
Hey, there's a safe room up ahead. You think he's in there?
Well, there's definitely someone in there, crying and huddled in the fetal position.
Thinker!
Julia? Oh, thank goodness you're here, Lieutenant! Be a dear and take care of this gangly fellow for me, would you? He's been blocking my way out all day.
What the heck is he? Oh, for the love of... Get down! Yo! Trapped in a dungeon! P.S. You might want to keep your eyes peeled for the personification of death itself!
Yes, that did occur to me. But sadly, Kibao informed me that the messenger doesn't work down here. Or reception and whatnot.
And you believed him? Of course. course you believed him. You're stupid enough to be in this situation after all. Hey, come on out to my tea party in the middle of this minefield. Aw, don't mind the razor wire. We have crumpets!
Julier!
We're gonna have some words with you two later, most of which I'd rather not use in front of you. But for now, just get my daughter and your dumb asses out of here!
Actually, Mama, I believe I could.
Now, now, child, let's not keep your mother waiting!
Don't worry, Kirito. I've got your back. With the two of us, our love can conquer anything!
The power of love is bullshit.
Shit!
Power of swords and violence. That's where the money is.
Yui!
Of course, on the other hand...
Immortal object?
Will this suffice? I imagine you have some questions.
Yeah, maybe a couple. First and foremost, what happened to your sweater, young lady?
Is that seriously what you want to ask her?
What? It was expensive. If she's just gonna lose it, then I'm not gonna keep buying her nice things.
As you have probably guessed by now, I am not a normal player. I am, in fact, a highly advanced artificial intelligence designed to psychologically evaluate and care for the players of Sword Art Online.
Wow!
Nation, Yui.
Oh my god! You're a psychiatrist AI? Well, I can certainly think of a few people who could have used your help.
Indeed. That is why I was so distraught when, on the day after day, constantly bombarded by the pain and anger of all the people I could not help, I gradually fell into despair. But then, all of that changed when I found you two.
Aww.
The most broken, sociopathic players I had ever laid eyes on. Less people than a loose collection of character defects.
In a different direction than I was expecting.
Yeah,
but somehow,
definitely.
Together, you were happy. Everything I knew about human relationships told me that one would eventually kill the other. And yet, no matter how often you fought, your bond only seemed to grow stronger. I decided that my information must be flawed in some way, and that I needed to amend it firsthand.
You mean...
I wanted to know what love is. I wanted you to show me.
Goddamn foreigner.
Oh!
Banned, right?
I am sorry I lied to you. I inserted myself into your lives merely to satisfy my own curiosity. At least, at first.
Oh, Yui.
Nice to be a part of your family. Hey, you do not have to pretend to love me anymore. I know you only kept me around as a pawn for your mind games.
Well, I mean, we were, but you're not!
Please do not cry, Mama. It is okay.
I've had privileges!
Kirito! What the heck is this?
I saved her, Asuna. I saved Yui.
I mean, now that I look more closely...
Oh, for the love of... That's not literally her. I just saved her data to my nerve gear as an in-game item. That way, when we finally beat this game, we can bring her back. And then we can tell her how we really feel.
Okay, well, damn.
Kirito.
Not bad, bro.
You're gonna need a tampon for that gigantic vagina you just screw.
I know. I'm gonna miss her, too.
Damn, bro.
Hey, Asuna? For real this time. No bullshit.
It, man, this was actually a fucking long ass episode, 20 fucking minutes, god damn. Barely probably said anything during this whole fucking shit because it was so fucking shocking just to see some of this stuff, but god damn, man, Yui, fuck, AI that used them and knowing that they was using her, ain't that some shit? This side quest was definitely something. God damn it. These motherfuckers was on 10, fighting with their fucking brains just to figure out if they really wanted to be together. Just had to talk it out. That is a life lesson to all of you. Talk the shit out. Because when you in your head doing that concocting, you're fucking up. But if you guys made it to the end of this video, do me a favor. Comment gold at the bottom, man. And let me know that you guys are supporting the content. And I will see you in the next reaction.